rooms 20 years ago as part of the Aussie phenomenon Neighbours. He went on to have a very successful music career, notching up 15 hit singles in the UK alone, and he's been busy this year with the release of his long-awaited autobiography and touring the country performing his greatest hits. You give me one good reason to leave me, I'll give you 10 good reasons to stay. You're the only one I believe in. I'll be hurt, walk away. Too many broken hearts in the world. There's too many dreams could be broken in two. Too many broken hearts in the world. So hammer. Please welcome Jason Donovan.
Then, Jason, because we were actually all singing along there, because we know it. It's like fabulous. I love it.
I can hear the people in the galley upstairs doing exactly the same thing.
Really?
Yeah, it's funny, that song.
What was it like, the tour, when you were sort of doing the old numbers and everything again? And the audience changed, or are they the same audiences who have grown up with you?
Slightly older. A lot of mums. But I think... I mean, it was slightly sort of autobiographical, this sort of show, and since doing the Jungle, it was an amazing sort of way to be able to reinvigorate some your sort of back catalogue and make sort of sense out of that period in your life. But I love performing live, but the opportunity to be able to do it the way you want to express yourself is why it's always that elusive thing of, you know, wanting to be a pop act so you can put on your own show, so you can tell your own story, as opposed to working for sort of producers that dictate
and tell you what to
tell
do.
You what to do. Well, so much so that we're actually doing it again next year.
Are you really going to go on tour again?
We have announced it. So
you've got the DVD of the tour as well, haven't you? That's coming out as
the
well.
The DVD is out at the moment. So you
where
know,
was
it's
that?
All,
where was that actually
that
filmed?
Was, that was filmed at Hammersmith, the Hammersmith Apollo. So
when you're on tour, what do you do with your kids? They go with you or?
Well, not really. I mean, they're six and seven, so they're pretty much at school. But, you know, again, I really tried to... they've sort of been the inspiration and a bit of a turning point in my life. So a part of this whole show, which is in the DVD, was to involve them in the sort of the arc of the show. So, again, it was slightly sort of autobiographical, and it was a bit of a pictures and postcards of my life in a funny sort of way.
You have you've written your autobiography. It's, it's done very well. Was that something that was? I mean, because you have to make decisions, I would imagine, when you tell the story of your life, especially when you've had sort of quite public ups and downs, of how truthful am I going to be? What bits am I not going to put in because it might hurt my family or it might involve people who are in the public eye, and I'm sort of telling stories out of school. Well, how do you go about making that sort of editing decision?
Well, I mean, I on the funny side of it, the flip side of it is it's a story I know a lot about. It's a subject I know a lot about. So I started from there. I didn't want to make a book that wasn't raw and honest. It was ghostwritten, but I spent a hell of a lot of time with the writer, and we catalogued my life. I think what happens in a public sort of life is very much, the press are very much interested when you're up there and when you're down there. And what I've got in this book is capturing the middle ground, and the middle ground enables you to be high and to be low, not necessarily in the sort of physical sense of taking drugs or, you know, going to work sort of every day, but you know, it's raw, it's honest, it's not, I didn't set out to make it inspirational, because I don't think it's not a lesson in how not to lead your life or how not to take drugs. But I think, going back to that subject, you know, we have choices in our lives, and going back to the subject of my children, we have a situation where we can educate our children to make the right choices in
with
life.
Your own experience.
And if you're passionate about something in your life, then you can overcome anything. I'm a firm believer of that, and I'm also a firm believer in physical exercise. I think, you know, depression can be solved through that medium as well.
One of the things you talked about in the book as well was your relationship, your romantic relationship mm-hmm. with Kylie sort of in the early days. It obviously did no damage to your friendship with her because she invited you to appear in a sketch with her on her show recently, didn't she?
Yeah, I mean, you know, how could I not include in my book, you know, a reference to her? But to say that the whole book was sort of written on the basis of our relationship is absolutely absurd.
Let's have a look at that sketch. Let's have
okay.
a look.
Oh, God.
What would you like for lunch today, Kylie?
Langoustine.
And a sandwich?
No. Hey!
Hey!
Hi! It's Kylie!
Hi. Sorry? She finally love Jason.
Go on.
There we go. Thanks
go
for the
on,
support.
Jace. Especially for you.
Sure. To Kylie. Kylie. Especially for you. Love Jason. There we go. Perfect. Take care.
It was
literally shot in the corridors out
yeah,
here.
Yeah, we recognise it.
But, it was a fleeting sort of day, but obviously, you know, to be able to sort of poke fun at the past and also, you know,
great.
It's an opportunity when all the press has sort of said that there is... I went back to Australia recently and picked up an article that said Donovan and Minogue end rift. I'm like, well,
what rift?
But I
tell
people
you what,
just move past.
Especially
you know?
For you, that duet that you did, you nearly made it to the legendary Christmas number one spot with that, didn't you? But was it Cliff who kept you off the top?
It was Cliff.
It wasn't Mistletoe Wine.
It was Mistletoe Wine.
Yeah. How did you ever recover from that humiliation?
Are you a fan of the... We're having this
Cliff's
debate. Are you a fan of Christmas songs being regurgitated every year or not?
I think the X Factor has basically taken that equation totally away, you know. But, you know, it's demand and supply. And, you know,
but
if people want to buy the record, they'll buy the record.
Do you like Christmas songs?
I do like Christmas songs.
What's your favourite? Your favourite cheesy Christmas song?
I don't have a cheesy... Well, I mean, I quite like... No, if I'm going to say... All right! If I'm going to say... Do They Know It's Christmas is the quintessential Christmas song.
Yeah.
But, you know, a bit of Slade now and again and a bit of, you know...
No, I like
I do
it.
Like... I actually do quite like Paul McCartney. Simply...
I
think that's so
out.
Cheesy and like... But I think... God, that guy has... Christmas. Sorry. That guy is he's part of Christmas and, you know...
Well, listen, thank you for being a part of our Christmas.
Thank
we wish you the best, the wish best to you and your family. We look
thank
forward
you
to
so
the new
much.
Tour.
Great.
Thank you
Perfect.
Very much, Jason
right,
Donovan.
Guys,
that wraps up the show for today, but we're back for more tomorrow at 12:30. Craig David will be here. We'll see you then.
Keep in touch with the girls, join in the debates and get video highlights on your mobile phone. Just text LOOSE to 83339. It'll cost 2 standard rate messages. Now, in just over half an hour, we have another brand new 60-minute makeover. That's at 2, right after the news. More on that in just a moment.